Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how I use the Reminders app. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So here's another video in my series about productivity. This is how I get things done on my Mac. And hopefully you can get some ideas from how I like to work. So here's how I make use of the Reminders app. I know a lot of people use the Reminders app to do exactly what the title suggests. They set reminders for themselves. And that's perfectly fine. I do that too. But in addition to that, I use it for two other things. One is to create to-do lists. And another is to create ideas lists. Now first, a to-do list. This is probably the second most popular thing to do with reminders. A lot of people do it, but not everybody thinks to use reminders this way. Whenever I have a task that I need to do, I'll put it in a to-do list. Now, you could have a daily to-do list. That's fine. I tend to just have an ongoing to-do list. These are things that I need to do at some point, maybe later today, maybe next week, and I want to put them in the list so I don't forget. At least once a day, I go through my to-do list and see what items are there and what I could maybe accomplish today. What I'm really using this for is to be able to get something out of my head. When I think I need to do something, if I don't write it down somewhere, I'm always thinking about it. I'm trying to remember to do it and it's distracting me from doing other things. If I put it in this list, I can get it out of my head knowing that I'm not going to forget about it. I'm going to see it again the next time I look at my to-do list. Now this is my demo account. In reality, I actually have several to-do lists. For instance, I have one that pertains to MacMost for getting things done with the MacMost site, YouTube channel, and so on. I have another one that has to do with mobile apps and other websites that I maintain. So this way if I'm at the end of the week and I decide to switch gears from working on MacMost stuff to working on something that needs to be done in one of my mobile apps, I can look at that specific list to see what's on it. Now another thing that I use reminders for that's more unusual is for idea lists. So a lot of times people ask me, how do I get the ideas to do daily videos for MacMost? Well, I get inspiration all the time from things I see, things I read, things I try out on my Mac. Whenever I get an idea, I put it in a list named MacMost Episode Ideas. I just add it in there. I don't really think too much about whether it's a good idea, a bad idea, whether I will be doing it or not. I just add it to the list. The actual list in my real account is more than 100 items deep. Now when I go to create a new MacMost video, if I'm not already thinking of an idea, I can just go to this list and look through it to see what's there. You could use this for whatever work you do. For instance, say you write fiction. You could have ideas lists for characters, for plot lines, for scenes, for all sorts of things. Anything you think of that's interesting, put it into a list in Reminders. I know writers and comedians and all sorts of creative people use little notebooks to keep ideas like this. I like to do it on the computer. I can even do it on my iPhone when I'm on the go so that it appears in my reminders list on my Mac. And sometimes I review these ideas lists and to-do lists while I'm on the go on my iPhone. It gets me thinking about things if I have downtime, like waiting in line or between innings at a baseball game, that kind of thing. I also like to use the notes feature inside Reminders. You can go in here and you could write a note with all sorts of details. So if it's an idea for a video and I've got some thoughts on what I should include, I can put it here in notes. You could actually include a lot of information in notes. You can write line after line of things and you'll be able to see them here on your Mac and your other devices as well. So I hope this also gives you some ideas on how you can use Reminders as well. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.